Hello everyone, in today's video I will start up making a Dynamo course for a beginner, and I'm making this one because I got lots of asks and demands to in the YouTube channel to create a step-by-step YouTube series based on Dynamo for beginners, and they actually asked to restructure the way I am giving the Dynamo course previously. Not by a practical base, but more than a step by step, and a shortened videos was the main things that lots of people was asking. So I'm trying to make this for very basic things in very short time, maybe not to pass more than 10 minutes for each video. Anyway, so it's basically I'm gonna talk about Dynamo as a concept and how it works and what types of Dynamo we have, and in this specific lecture I will talk about the introduction, and I will try to give the you know, the basic knowledge and the basic definition of Dynamo, as long as lots of people, you know, still asking what is the you know, the main reason we use Dynamo and why and what it can do and who should, you know, work on it. I wish that the time goes enough within this 10 minutes, and if it's not, I'll try to split this introduction into two pieces. Anyway, about me, for those new subscribers, my name is Firas and I'm an instructor at the architecture department, Ajman University, UAE, master in design and sustainable from the University of Sydney, and master in science in architecture engineering, University of Technology, and I'm certified Autodesk Revit professional since 2013. So enough about me. Dynamo. I'll try to make it less dry and less PowerPoint, you know, course, but I cannot give you and deliver the definition without, you know, in exact words. I'm taking from different resources, so I'm gonna add the resources that I have at the, you know, at the description of this introduction. Do urge you to have a look at them. I might change some words, and I give all the credit for those who actually, you know, in the references that I'm gonna add. I'm just revising and changing some knowledge based on my experience. So Dynamo, as a definition, it's 100%, you know, it's like it's a visual programming platform, and people who use it are, you know, working in different fields and different majorities, and they are all trying to achieve a specific type of use and benefits for things that they not actually have before, or trying to create, let's say, a small software. It's not making software, but rather making a small chores that actually couldn't be done, or not actually there is tool to do it before in the main software they use. So that's basically Dynamo. It's just a visual programming tool, because lots of people think it's a pure programming. And that push us, you know, trying to understand, for those who don't understand the programming, it's just an act of a formalization and a process and making serious actions into executable programs. So you're targeting, you're doing a couple of stuff together in order to create a program. And this program, or this, it's a like an algorithm. It's like you're giving specific sets of orders and things, trying to get a result. And usually it's based and depend on, you know, your ability to understand the patterns and how you you know, able to analyze it and find the link and between them, and how you rationalize them and see the possibilities, how it goes to get you to the result. Anyway, mainly there is two types of programming, the visual one and the textual one. So if you go to a visual one, you actually use, it's like a systematic relationships, and there's diagrams. Again, it's all based on making algorithm, and you define the instruction and relationship based on part of that through graphical visual user interface. So you are not actually leaving this fancy word aside. You can read on your own leisure. It's in visual programming. We actually don't use much of text, you know, and kill ourselves with the syntax and how it's actually should be written and all that stuff. But rather, we have, you know, we have like those like batteries or nodes, and each represent a specific command. This is visual programming. It's very, very simplified, where you have, you know, a node, and each node do specific commands. So if you are, you know, working in AutoCAD or working 3D Studio Max, you 100% know that there's a command called circle. Well, welcome. This is the circle, you know, like in the visual. You don't write circle or C space. Can't remember AutoCAD shortcuts anymore. I forgot, even I teaching it. And you don't need to write circle and then hit a space in AutoCAD, or go in 3D Studio Max to the command panel and click on the circle button to get the, you know, the command circle. But rather in here, we have this thing, you know, this node, and it needs an input, and those are the inputs need the center point, and it needs the radius. And it's very similar to what you do in AutoCAD by providing or answering the question that happened to be shown in the command bar. And, you know, like, you give the center point as a point, and you give the radius, and then Dynamo will draw it for you. So this is basically visual programming. So you're not really typing. That's the terrifying piece for lots of us, you know, because if you are if you're coming from an architectural background, probably you will be doing less, you know, text. This is the same thing, exactly the same thing, where X and Y is giving, and radius is giving as, you know, text instead. And the point, it's not a command now, it's not a battery or an node now, and it's not an AutoCAD button, or some pushy thing that you have to click on to get the result. No, you have to go with the syntax here and the text here exactly, and be careful, you know, where you put gaps and you put, that's a little bit of annoying when you do, you do the textual programming, and you're gonna get the same result. And depend on what you do and how you do it, you probably get this enough. So you don't need to be freaking out and go that way. And you see, oh no, I'm not gonna learn Dynamo because, you know, it have lots of text. It's not like that. You, not by necessity, you know, you need a text way of doing it. So this is what I learned. I've been learning it like around 3 years now, and the majority of my work is here. And it's I know it might be, you know, intimidating, a little bit scary for architects specifically when they jump from the way they deal with you know, the more visual, not programming interfaces, but to deal with their design. But now, you know, that's this is also will be easier if you just try to give it some time, and you'll start to think differently. Maybe not, we need to write it in on textual base like this one, but I don't think it's gonna be you know, that much, depending on the need and this, and then on the level of the work you're gonna, you know, need in your work. So again, back to the definition, we said that Dynamo is a visual programming platforms, so it's not one platform, and used by a wide range of people to achieve a wide range of benefits, you know, which has not been usually provided. So here we need to talk a bit about, you know, platforms. So if I go and, you know, and try to see how many platforms we have and how many flavor we have for Revit, it's just basically three. And those are Dynamo as a plugin, and Dynamo Studio, and Dynamo Sandbox. And Dynamo plugin for me is the one that I, you know, work on lots of times in it. And as we said, it's a plugin, so it's you know, have to be within you know, a small program built in and installed automatically within other platform or other software like Revit for Dynamo, like the one that I have in here, which is 100% needs you to open Revit, and then you go to the Manage tab. And from the Manage tab, you jump to press this Dynamo thing, and you're gonna get the Dynamo screen open, with a logo of Revit above. And in this dude here, when you open it, this is the main Dynamo core, plus, you know, the ability to deal with any geometry coming from Revit. So you're going to find something called here Revit, and you're going to find the Revit elements commands or nodes, let's say, already here available for you. So you can deal with the selection, you can deal with the geometry elements, and those elements you can find like curtain systems, curtain types, types of wall, families, you know, things that might not really need to be existed in the other plugin. So when you say that it's a Dynamo plugin base, you have to know which software it's work for, and let's say in the majority of our work, Revit. So you're gonna find Dynamo Core, that's a new term for us, which is, you know, a collection of a bundle of a component that consists of the geographical interface and the computer plugin engine, and it's just, you know, the main engine that Dynamo needs to run the whole thing, plus, you know, the tool or the set of command that Dynamo need in order to, you know, program what you need inside Dynamo. Again, that's the logo for it. And if you see the other platforms, there's lots of other platforms and that actually can run or have Dynamo in it. The second one, the second dude here is Dynamo Studio. So before I jump to Dynamo Studio, Revit's plugin, as a plugin for Revit, you don't need to install it. All you need to install Revit, and you're gonna find that already, you know, installed for you. This dude here, Dynamo Studio, is a standalone, you know, visual programming platform. So it's fully functionally away from, you know, it's here. It's fully functionally away from Revit, and when you start it, you can have everything that have actually or exist in the Dynamo core, and you know, the difference, it doesn't have anything related to Revit, so it's a pure programming, visual programming base without being specifically dedicated, nor having any tool here for, you know, for Revit specifically. It's a paid software, so you have to pay for it, or, you know, you have to install it for a student license or educational license. That's different, and that's what make it different from the third type, what we call it, Dynamo SandBox. I rarely use that, and there's two definitions for that. I will leave you to bore yourself with reading them, but specifically, it's free. That's what I wanted. Just I highlight this for you, so we don't need to go bore ourselves to death with this reading definition. It's a free. That's the difference between it and the Dynamo standalone, because this one is also standalone, and you can run it without the need of Revit, and it's isn't integrated. And the difference here, it's like a limited functionality. So it's like a light version of what you have here in Dynamo, standalone. And when you click on it like this, see how happy? You're gonna get a free package of Dynamo, and it's a standalone. And you can test and see the packages you downloaded from internet, and you have to do small jobs and Dynamo, not the full functionality that you can have and reach in, you know, the Autodesk Dynamo Studio. So I think that's enough for, you know, getting us to the types of Dynamo. I will try to explain more related to who you need to use the Dynamo, and you know, what type of fields, and I will keep that, because I passed like exactly now 10 minutes. Passing 10 minutes, sorry, with around like 15 minutes actually. So I'm gonna keep doing the, you know, the series based on like a 15 minute video. So that's enough for introduction part one. See you in the second part in the coming days. Thank you very much and have a good day.